mistake allow us to extend our warm greetings to our estimated judges and respected participants. First, let me introduce myself. My name is Faisal Rahmat. I am from Physics Education Study Program, Faculty of Mathematics and Natural Science, Pakistan State University. To be honest, I am deeply honored and proud to stand as one of semifinalists in the International Wali Songo Science Competition. Through this presentation, I hope to share and contribute to the ongoing advancement of science. Thank you for this opportunity, and I'm ready to begin the presentation. My presentation make a meaningful contribution in maintaining momentum of scientific progress. In this science project, several tools and material are used, including a circuit board, a rubber, string, and stone as a block. The assembly is done as follows. The circuit board is connected to the rubber with the help of a string. Then a loop is attached to the end of the rubber band. After it's all, observe what happens. From this observation, several questions arise. 1. How does the system move? When the load is attached to the rubber band, the system moves as a follow. The load causes the rubber band to stretch due to the force of gravity acting on the load. The stretched rubber band creates a restoring force that is proportional to the displacement according to Hooke's law. Force equals min kx, where k is the spring constant and x is the displacement. The system will oscillate vertically as the restoring force pulls the load back up and gravity pulls it back down, resulting in up and down motion until it eventually comes to rest an equilibrium position where the force balances out. The next topic is how many constraints are there in the system. There are several constraints in the system, including 1. Blood can only move in the vertical direction, up and down. This restricts the movement to one dimension only, y-axis it is. 2. Additionally, the rubber band spring has limit to how much it can stretch, so the mass of the load must be considered according to the type of spring used. The next question is, how many degrees of freedom are there in the system? degrees of freedom are the number of independent movement available in the system. In the system, the load can only move up and down along the y-axis. Therefore, the system has 1 degree of freedom, which is the vertical movement y-axis. The last question is, find the equation of motion for the system. After performing the analysis using the Lagrangian equation, it was found that the equation of the line that satisfies the system is as shown on the screen. Thank you for your attention during this presentation. We have explained about the system consisting of the rubbers, circuit board, the loads, and a string. As well, we have explained the whole system can move, the constraint, and its degree of freedom. This experiment demonstrates how physical laws such as a Hooke's law work in everyday life. We hope this presentation has enriched your brain understanding of basic physics principles. Thank you for your attention. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.